Hello, this is day one of Grammy School cooking, and we're going to be cooking with some friends today. I'm Grammy. My name is Jane Clark, and this is my granddaughter Jade. Hi, Jade.
Wow.
Our neighbor Isabel. Isabel, say hi to
Hi.
Karis, say hello.
Hi, Mom.
And Ariel.
Hi to the camera.
Okay, we're going to be making a couple kinds of meatballs today. We already have prepared some ingredients. We have 2 pounds of mixed hamburger, veal, and pork. 2 eggs. We've got about 1/2 cup of shredded parsley, 1/2 cup of milk. This is 1 teaspoon of black pepper, 2 teaspoons of salt. We've got about 1/2 tablespoon of onion powder because the girls really do not like onions. But otherwise, if you wanted to make onions, you would dice up 1 onion and saute that first and add that in here. And in here, along with the onion powder, we have 1/2 teaspoon of red pepper. Okay, so we need 1/3 cup of plain breadcrumbs. Even though we're making Italian meatballs today, we're going to use plain breadcrumbs and add the Italian seasoning later. Garlic crust, working on it over here. Okay, I think we're going to have, we might need a hammer for this. How are we going to crush this garlic? Try a fork. We don't have a garlic press, so let's see. It looks even bigger than dice, doesn't it? It's got to be crushed. Crushing the garlic. I don't know if that's crushed, but it certainly is.
It looks like
the least dice.
It looks like it's lighter.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Italian herb seasoning. We need 1 teaspoon of it. And we can mix that in. Go together anyway. All mushed together. Then to prepare the bacon cheese, we are going to lightly spray this.
Invisible spray!
The reason I sprayed it over the sink was because if I sprayed it so it got on the floor, people would be drinking. And that would be really funny on camera.
Yeah, that would be funny.
You don't want to do that. So, the breadcrumbs will need to be soaked in milk. So let's add the milk. Actually, let's get this back out.
I have to put the cheese in a separate spot.
Put it right there. No, this is perfect.
The power of cheese.
You ruined
it. And this illustrates the importance of reading all your directions ahead of time. Now we want to add the milk to this and let it soak. We gotta get kinda gum up a little bit.
Whoa. It's going to flow. What is it to flow?
Stir that gently so it doesn't spill. It's completely mixed, and then we're going to let that
It looks like oatmeal.
Now, during this time, we would have been sauteing the onions, but we're not sauteing the onions because
onions are
lucky. So we do need to let this turn into a kind of a paste to you. Here, it's starting to turn into a paste to you, but we want to be goofier than that. We have to let that sit for a little bit, so while we're letting that sit. Alright, now we're going to start our next set of meatballs, which are sweet and sour. And I got these from allrecipes.com, the best sweet and sour meatballs. It says prep 20 minutes, cook 30 minutes, ready in an hour. First, we need
That looks so good.
Kirkland.
That looks so good.
Yes, it's organic ground beef. Oh, this is pretty lean.
It's mushy.
Yeah. I want to touch it.
Yeah. It's mushy.
It's squishy. Combine the ground beef, egg, breadcrumbs, and
onion. I'm going to eat this one.
One. So we got ground beef, egg, breadcrumbs, and onion all together. Onion. Breadcrumbs, go ahead and put those in.
Ew.
Egg.
Ew, you got egg on you. Whoa.
Are you going to need to stir?
Trying to break that up a little bit without spilling.
Are you going to need to stir this?
It needs to be
stirred. It's a lot of
stir it.
You can do some. Go ahead and mix that in a little bit.
Ew.
Are you not used to seeing eggs?
I am.
If you want to stir an egg without a spilling, it's like a circular motion, like this. Like you're scooping up and you go back over. So faster, faster, faster.
Granny,
it's
always faster. Yeah, it's faster for your spilling.
That looks so
yummy.
That
looks
so yummy.
Yeah, it looks like
without spilling it, get it all around the edges too.
Wow. That's
wild.
That looks so.
It's okay. Then it says mix thoroughly and shape into golf ball size ball.
Can I get those in my hands?
Which
oh,
one can I
ball.
Do?
By the way, if you touch your face or anything
do?
Else unclean, you have to wash your hands again. Yeah.
Which one
do I like the idea of the little ones better for this.
Yeah. Yeah, but
it only looks like sand.
Tell me about it.
I like the way it's balanced.
Isabel just added 1 packed cup of brown sugar to 1.5 cups of water.
And it fell in. It was hilarious.
This is the first part of our sweet and sour sauce. Yeah. Next thing we're going to add is 3 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. We've got 1 cup of vinegar to add to water and brown sugar. Three tablespoons of soy sauce. Add that to the mixture.
Oh my goodness.
Stir it up.
So can I stir it?
Mixture. Flour. It says in a large saucepan, combine the brown sugar, flour, water, white vinegar, and soy sauce. Mix thoroughly. Add meatballs and drain and bring to a boil. We're going to cook the meatballs next.
Can I stir it after, Jay?
Come on over to the stove. Half the brown meatballs here. So that is on medium heat. Make sure they're nice and round. Put them in. That's
nice.
Water, 1/4 cup of 95% lean organic ground beef. So these will be a very lean meatball. And as they're browned in, they're put into the red pan on the stove. Which has in it the 1 cup of packed brown sugar, 3 tablespoons of all purpose flour, 1.5 cups of water, 1/4 cup of distilled white vinegar, and 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. That hasn't been turned on yet. Right now they're browning the meat. They're putting it into the pan as it's browned. And once all the meat is browned, we're going to turn on the sauce with meatballs in it and let the temperature boil and then simmer for about 30 minutes after they boil. While they're working on that, we over here are going to get back to our original recipe that we started with, which was Chef John's Italian Meatballs, and that's found on allrecipes.com. We have our meat mixture here, which I actually purchased meat that's 3 kinds of meat together. And this is veal, beef, and pork mixed together. And that's 2 pounds of that. And now we're going to add the other ingredients. The goofy stuff right here is the next thing to add, and these are the breadcrumbs and the milk. I'm going to just sort of plop that in. It's going to be really stuffy. So she's going to scoop that in. See how thick it is? It's almost like oatmeal. Let's add the spices next. All of it in one after another. Good. very hot.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm going to get your fork.
Yeah. It's really hot, so you need to
wait a second.
Whoa.
Oh.
They're done. Oh, they look beautiful. Because of other things. Okay. Look at those meatballs.
They
look like
four. Ow! Sorry.
Out of the
heat. Look really good.
Look
really
good.
I want to
smell
really good.
Smell on it before you put it in your mouth so you don't burn yourself.
I'm waiting. That's good. That is good.
Ready for the Italian meatballs?
Thanks very much for joining us.